Okay, and here we are coming into downtown Monroe, Georgia. We think this is just really a cool, rather small Georgia town. And obviously it's full of antique malls and I guess just a lot of good old southern charm. How's that? So here's downtown. Walton Mill sign. It's actually the second driveway on your right. The first one is to the loading dock, and the second one is here where this van's coming out. So we're going to turn in there. The big building straight in front of me here, I believe, is some auxiliary storage that Ian had talked about potentially having a flea market or an antique fair coming up in the spring. So we'll see if that happens. You can see they got some stuff outside here as well. Here we are. Good afternoon. Good, thank you. And we're coming down the first aisle here. You can just get an idea looking down the aisle how big this mall is. And this is just the top floor. This mall's got two floors in it. And here's another aisle. And another aisle. And we're going to turn down this one because I think the cool stuff is down here. And I'm sure by now that you might have a good idea of what I consider the cool stuff, which would of course be train and toy related. Looks like we've got quite the festive person here next to us with the bunny rabbits and Easter decorations. And here is our triple antique booth here in Monroe. You can see it's a big one and it's pretty well stocked, as you might expect. So just tons of trains, die-cast cars, models, Plasticville, some Matchbox, Hot Wheels, Hess trucks. And then again, some more, a bunch of 143rd scale die cast, 164th scale, some Marx, some Richard Petty stuff, a bunch of little Skyline metal houses there, and more Signals and Plasticville, Marx, tank cars. Whew, tons of good stuff. All right, so we're gonna just kind of stroll around the mall a little bit more. Finish going down this aisle. And you can see there's a great variety and assortment of more cool antiques, glassware, lamps, you name it, they got it. And let's go ahead and go downstairs now. Take a peek down here. It's very cool. Got one of those nice Lionel puzzles framed hanging up on the wall. $21, not a bad price, I might add. And so here we are downstairs. Cool kitchen stuff. Nice furniture. Bunch of records, record posters, jewelry. Even got a booth full of all kinds of tools and clocks. And I think back here, tucked away in the corner, if I remember, was a pretty cool booth as well. Yeah, got a couple of trains, some furniture, fireplace mantles. You can see this is another shot down the main, one of the main aisles downstairs. So the other stairway that was at the front is right here. So we'll go ahead and go up this stairway. Here's Mitch again. So here's the other front aisle upstairs. How about a Keebler tree? Everybody needs one of those. Old cash register, draperies. There's a Coors sign, some old books. There's a case full of interesting looking knickknacks. Tons of glassware here. And there's Mitch, decided to get ahead of me. Some dolls. Old record player, an old 8mm projector, mantel clocks, glassware. Fishing rods, some more tools. Even the Dick Pope Jr. water ski. Yeah, I had a pair of them when I was a kid. Water skiing up at Devil's Lake, Michigan. Fabulous. Some nice glassware. Here's another room with a lot of architectural kind of stuff. Looks like some gears and some things that are actually from when this was a cotton mill.